Hi, in this groov workshop, we're going to look at how to connect groov directly to a PQube Modbus TCP slave device and build a mobile page for it so I can monitor and control it with a mobile device. We'll need groov 2.3 or higher, either in your groov box or groov server for Windows, a PSL PQube Power Monitor, the PQube User's Manual for your device and tag configuration settings. For my PQube device, I'll check the manual to find the addresses of some values I want to view and clear from my mobile device. The manual shows 7000 as the default base address for the PQube. The first tag value I want to monitor is the AC voltage of L1. That's at offset 8, so the address will be 7008, and it's a float. I'll make note of the other values I want to monitor and control too. Once I've gathered all this info, I'll configure the connection to my PQube and add the tag settings. Here, using a modern web browser, I'm in groov build, where I'll select configure, devices and tags, then add new device and Modbus device. I'll type in a name like PQube, its IP address, the slave ID. The default port is fine. Then a couple of configuration settings. In this case, we're not using base 1 addressing since the PQube addresses start at 0. These function codes apply to writing values. These last two data interpretation settings refer to word order or endianness. For the PQube, I need to uncheck these. I'll click Add Device. Next, I'll configure that VAC tag and others I looked up in the PQube manual. Click Configure Tags. Give it a name. That VAC value is a float. Holding registers support both reading and writing, and the address I want is 7008. I'll just be reading this one, but groov does support writing too. I don't need to do any scaling to convert this input into different units, but I could if I wanted to, a handy option. We'll save and add another. Add one to clear peaks, which uses an integer data type. Address 7191, doing a write. Then I'll add a few more float values to monitor. The PQube has a huge selection of data values to choose from. I've selected just a handful here. The process is the same for adding those tags to groov. When I'm done, I'll click Close and close again. I've already created a page here with some images and groov header gadgets. Now I can use these new tags, which show up here in my tag list under my new PQube device. If I click on the tag first, the gadgets are filtered based on the data type of the tag. I can then drag and drop or just double click the gadget I want. I'll start with that peak value, then add a button to do the clear. It's super easy and fun. I can adjust these a little. Now I'll add a level indicator gadget for the watts value here. I'll make it vertical, then adjust some of these gadget properties. I can change the color to red by clicking on this box here. Adjust the size a little here to make it fit my page. Adding all the other gadgets is just as easy. Here's a trend so I can see how these values change over time. We'll add a couple of pens for my VAC and frequency values. Groov can support up to 4 pens on a single trend. There are a bunch of options that let me adjust this trend gadget. For a more detailed look at the trend gadget, check out the Groov Workshop video, Working with Trends. And next, I'll add a round gauge here for power factor, including a couple of zones, which are also super easy to add. I'll adjust my start value to -1, and my end value to -0.9, and change the color to red. I'll add a second zone from 0.9 to 1. But here's where it gets even more exciting. While I was building this page for my desktop or tablet, groov automatically built this handheld version of the page for me. Notice here I can move any gadgets I don't want on the smaller screen over here to the stash area. Now I can adjust the layout of the gadgets I want. I'll grab these three gadgets and drag them up to the top. I'll move my clear peaks button up and adjust them exactly how I want. Perfect! So now I have my handheld and desktop and tablet view just how I want them. Now to save my layout, I'll select File, Save All and switch to Groov View. My PQube values are showing up nicely. My trend is starting to populate with data and my gauges are working too. I'll try out my clear button here, which zeroes out that peak for me as expected. Let's check it out on my iPhone. Excellent! Just that fast with zero programming, I'm getting Modbus data from the PQube Power Monitor into Groov. I built a PQube page for my mobile device in just minutes. Now I can control and monitor my PQube from anywhere. Check out more Groov videos on groov.com. Thanks for watching.